fine.
It died.
Well, yeah.
Boy. Come, boy. Destroyed.
Even if we could take the card up, the next platform broke when we fought the dragon. Did you already forget?
Atreus, to me.
Okay, I'm coming.
Hmm. Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all. Ah, isn't that neat? Yes, dear boy. What can I do for you? Born in that armor. Something else for you, then? What else was there?
I told you. We should come back with the cipher. Another name. Rota!
It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
Thank you.
Still can't believe he ate it. There's something down there. Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess. Legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people, a selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
We're not getting in there without a key.